ahead of us.
Can I push him in?
You've got my vote.
I just want to sleep, yo, for like a week.
I guess we all could. We wanted to.
Yeah. The first is scrunch, so... What do you think we should do, Buffy?
Yeah, you're not the one and only chosen anymore. Just gotta live like a person. How's that feel?
Yeah, Buffy. What are we gonna do now?
Hello everyone! Welcome to Supermarket House, a brand new channel aimed to have fandoms feel right at home. My name's JC, and I'll be blabbing about all the geeky stuff you probably know about, but might still want to hear more. Today, we'll be talking about the cult hit Buffy the Vampire Slayer. Now, most of you know that the show ended in 2003, followed by one of TV's biggest cliffhangers in the spin-off Angel, 1 year after. What most people don't know is that the show has continued for 3 more seasons on a comic book series by Dark Horse Comics. Of course, we've had a few fellow nerds point that out.
Firefly did a movie to wrap things up. Buffy the Vampire Slayer continued on as a comic book. Heroes gradually lowered the quality season by season till we were grateful it ended.
Last time we saw Buffy, she was leaving the huge crater formerly known as Sunnydale with a team of brand new Slayers. So where are they now? They are a group of freaking commandos, kicking butts and taking names. Meanwhile, Xander is running things over at HQ, doing his best Nick Fury impersonation.
How does Fury even see these?
He turns.
Sounds exhausting.
What about everyone's favorite redhead witch? The last time we saw her, she was busy bringing an army of Slayers into the world. So what is she doing? Flying, of course. Willow establishes herself as the Wicca Supreme of Earth and taps into unbelievable magic, making her the key mystical element in the Slayer's arsenal. As mentioned in the last episodes of Angel, Willow is now tinkering with dimensional travels, and this will lead her to Alowyn, a demon sorceress, but more on that later. But what about Dawn? Oh boy, it must be Tuesday cause she's in a lot of trouble. She cheated on her boyfriend and paid the price by getting cursed. Textbook Joss Whedon. She is now doomed to change forms in the most freakish way possible. From a giant kaiju, to a big old centaur, to a living Chucky style doll, until she apologizes. Finally, we have Giles and Faith. Giles recruited Faith to hunt down a rogue slayer, and in the process ended up bonding with her in a similar paternal role as he did with Buffy. Of course we know, Buffy would not be happy with this. But in the end, this bond between them will play a critical role in the next season. Season 8 also showcases a cast of familiar faces from the show. Most of the supporting cast is back to help the Slayer Commandos in their crusade against the things that go bump in the night. Among them is the geek supervillain from the trio turned hero, Andrew. Others, like Harmony, left their jobs at Wolfram and Hart to expand in the new universe. A new universe where vampires are no longer hiding from society. She even lands a job as a reality show celebrity and has her own TV show with her charming touch. Another very interesting cameo comes from the Master of Darkness himself, Dracula, who we last saw in the season 4 premiere episode. This time, we get to further explore the master-minion relationship he has with Xander. Some characters like Riley have a one-shot issue showing how they're doing their best to help Buffy against this season's big bad. But when it comes to Tara, I'm sorry to say we won't be seeing her coming back anytime soon. Buffy the Vampire Slayer Season 8 definitely strays away from the TV show's formula, but it makes an amazing job at picking up where the series ended, recreating a whole new world outside of Sunnydale and into the new Buffyverse. The storyline this season dwells in familiar concepts with a new twist. The themes of relationships are back, but now are exploring a new angle. As mentioned before, Willow goes from seeing Kennedy to begin a relationship with Alowyn, the trickster demon. Xander is also trying to start a new relationship with one of the Slayers, but unfortunately it doesn't end well. Don't worry about Xander, Destiny has other plans for him. This season is by far the craziest thing that's ever gone down for the Scoobies. It's action-packed, thrilling, and with its fair share of funny conversations and awkward jokes. Fortunately, there are other familiar faces that join in, building into the main plot of the story, becoming a force against the Slayers, and giving power to its season's big bad, Twilight, who you might also know as... You know what? Let's leave that for another video. There are still some characters from a certain spin-off that play a critical role in this season and we need to talk about them. But that's all the time we got for today. Next time we'll see just how crazy this season can get. But before we go... Juliet Landau, the actress behind Drusilla, is making the Ultimate Vampire documentary, and she needs our help. So right now we want to give a big shout out to her and to her Indiegogo page. Go check that out and we'll see you all next time.
Achieve our purpose, and we are all more strong together.